Yo, what's up everyone? Welcome back to some more chess. Looks like we're going black. This is such a chill opening. Now I'm gonna mess it all up though. Is this some next level bait where they like take it with the knight or something? I want to set up for this fork with the bishop. I think I just take. Move the knight up, which would be interesting. I don't really see it helping me out though. Threatening this pawn. Once the knight out, it doesn't really have a nice place to go to. Now, where can you hide? Right there, I guess. there. I think this is just a good capture for me. Oh, I didn't see they can just move the rook there. Maybe lifting the pawn was actually the better move there. But this puts even more pressure on the potential fork. This right here is a very elegant move. Though I'm not sure how good it is. It kinda lets the rook pin my knight. Which isn't great. I think I have good retaliations though. Oh, you know what would be a great move? Is move this rook up to right there. Which I think I actually will do here. So you're threatening mate here, so what I do is check. I can either move the king or lift a pawn. This is mate in one, I think. That was a good game. I feel like I played, overall, I played that pretty cleanly. This is a strange start. I think I'll go with it. Threatening. I think bring the bishop out. Try to get a cheesy mate, maybe. I was about to say I have a very interesting move, queen to right there next to the knight. Obviously that would work though. So if I take here, the rook gets its own free file, but I think I'm okay with that. It's a very interesting position. If I move this knight up, it'll be defended. Queen. I think I'm fine with making this trade. Kind of an interesting pin, but I need to set up for it. I think castling here is actually not the worst idea. I'm really happy with where the knight is. I think that's just forfeiting the knight, unless there's some reason this diagonal is good. I'm very worried against this opponent because I feel like there's a lot of things going on here. So, if I move the rook there, my fear is that this pawn just gets dropped, which both attacks and defends the knight. Which obviously is not super ideal. What else could I do? I could threaten the rook. No, that's bad. Threaten the rook with a knight. I think I do the easy move, which is just keep up the attack. The pawn move is possible, but I feel like even with that, my position is still very strong. Because all their pieces are very, very segmented. Also, an interesting idea, dragging this bishop here to attack the queen. Actually, I think that's still. Move this, and then I can get a check out, and they just have to move the king. And there's very few places the king can go after the check is placed. So here's what I'm thinking. I check, they can't defend with any pieces. I can still put you in check here. Actually, no, even better, I attack the queen. Now you have some decisions to make, because that queen is not defended. It's attacking the knight, but they're still very far away from mate. And I think the rook is forfeit now. Oh, that was a resignation. Yeah, because once the king moves, it's only got one place it can move. Wait, isn't that checkmate? No, they can protect with the knight or bishop. But I did have a diagonal line on the other rook, which is why that move was so nice. Oh, I forfeit the bishop. But I could protect with the queen, actually. Which would be an interesting early trade. Oh, I see. How did this game go so wrong? Wait, my plan is dumb. Checkmate here, but the knight protects it. Check. This isn't how you're supposed to play the game. No takebacks. You just took like a billion of my pieces. I'm not gonna let you take something back. That's dumb. I don't know where this game is going. I kinda wanna get my king out. But not like that. Oh, that would pin myself. Have to stay protecting the knight. I think this spot is a little bit more options, though. I can't develop the rooks there. Although they could attack the bishop. Which would be interesting. Does let me get a really nice fork. I think that might be the greatest comeback of all time. Oh my gosh. I didn't breathe that whole match. They didn't see the mate. Look at how cornered that king was. Let's look at the analysis. Oh cool, I unlocked blunders. Alright, let's go back to the start. That's interesting. It says the first move can be a blunder. It doesn't like the early game queen trade. That's interesting. Oh, that's right. Queen wasn't protecting that pawn though, right? So I could have protected it there by lifting this pawn. So I'll know to do that if I see that approach in the future. It also protects against the knight moving forward. But I was focused on reinforcing this pawn instead, which probably puts me in a better position than this. It doesn't mind that. I think minus means it likes it. So yeah, that's a big minus for both of us. Nice. The opening to this is really good. Xc3. Oh, okay. So, the reason it's big mad there is because if you take that and then I take this, you have this option, which is very strong, and that's just a free pawn. Anyways, back to the game. Queen take would have protected, okay. The bishop. I forgot about the bishop. That would have protected the knight. Yeah. So a lot of early game mistakes. Doesn't mind that one, that's minus nine. That's threatening the pawn. Oh, I think. Yeah, so this knight is defended if it goes there. But if they do that, take, take. This knight is in a really weird neighborhood. I can approach like this and force a move. Something like that. And now this knight is just way in the middle of nowhere. Game is gone. It's hard to play for two people. In accuracy, taking queen is better. Or does this only shows white as blue? Sent to pawn. Loss. What does learn from your mistakes do? That covers all the bases. The queen can't take anything there without getting hit. Let's look at the enemy's mistakes. Okay, so early game it doesn't like gambit style. You just take the rook? Yeah. Oh, this was my favorite move. Is evaluating. That's a good move. Oh yeah, it's forced and then you've mate. Wait! They threw mate away because they got scared. Oh wait, no, the bishop is there. It's still a weird spot to be in though. I thought that was just straight up mate there. I think on the diagonal, I like this move next. Oh, it's saying this move. Yeah, that is a safe move. And then here to protect, and then giant advantage. Oh, wait. Supposed to give it up. I guess. Well, ice card bishop can't do much. This is interesting seeing engine moves. Look at the arrows go. Alright. Let's go over this again. Moving queen up is bad because the bishop would protect. If they attack this pawn, what happens? I think I just push this pawn, and then their pawn structure is really awkward. Wait, no, after they take pawn. Oh, I just move out the knight. Yeah. I move the knight to right there. So I only made two big mistakes. What about inaccuracies? Jump. Alright, if you enjoyed this episode of Chess, leave a like, let me know how you're feeling about the series. I'll see you on the next one.